Good morning.
And welcome to Live with Luggy.
Yes, happy Thursday, April 29th. Great to see you.
Oh my gosh, great to see you on this Thursday morning.
Awesome.
Let's go ahead and get started.
Let's do it. Here we go with our Pledge of Allegiance. Everybody ready? Salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands. One nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Now our Shamrock Pledge, take it away.
We are the scholars of Shamrock Gardens. We are dedicated, committed, and focused. We prepare for greatness by doing our best every day. We cooperate with our classmates, teachers, and staff. We respect ourselves and all people. We know that hard work is the key to success. There are no limits to how far we can go. We dream big, believe, and achieve. We will graduate from high school and be college and career ready. We will succeed.
Yes, we will.
We will. Oh. You know what? Let me go see what happened to that chef. Let me see if
maybe running late today. You might be like chopping something or Julianne. Is that the really difficult chopping method? Julianning some vegetables? Or dicing or slicing.
Oh, excuse me. I was just julienning some vegetables. Did I hear someone talking about chopping of vegetables? Yes.
I didn't know if you were julienning or dicing or slicing or mincing or what.
Oh, yes. Yes. And you know what? Some little children have told me that I resemble a Miss Palsgrove and that maybe I'm even infiltrating her office to tell you things about the menu. But as you can see, my background right here is green. It's over here. So clearly not in her office. Today we have delicious nuggets of chicken. We also have a garlic breadstick, a seasoned crinkle cut potatoes, a fruit cocktail, and a variety of milks. In case you're looking ahead to tomorrow, you know we have tomorrow we have the cheese dipper. So cheese dipper Friday.
Are you prepping those veggies for Friday as well?
Yes. Yeah. Also, we'll be having I'm roasting the corn and I am dicing the pears.
Oh, sounds fantastic. Thank you, Chef. Oh, that chef is something else. Well, we hope that everyone is continuing to read some poems. I know that we have tried out a variety of poems that we have shared with you, and we're trying to break that stigma of poetry, you know, just being kind of boring. I know when I was younger, I thought poetry was very boring. But as I was growing up, I was like, oh my gosh, they don't even have to rhyme. You know, you can make them funny, you can make them silly. So we hope that you are continuing to read some haikus, whatever, at home and school. Wonderful. All right. Oh, Thinking Maps Thursday.
Thinking Maps Thursday.
All right. I got to get our faces out of here. Let's see. I think we're good. Hope we're good here, friends. I'll move it in a moment.
Now, so, you know, our scholars loved the Health Tips Tuesday about poison ivy so much that we thought we would make a double bubble map to compare poison ivy with poison oak.
Oh, so there's two things that are poison.
There's also poison sumac, but we'll talk about that later. Yes, they both actually look very similar. And as you're looking at them, you can see they both have three jagged leaves. They're also both kind of shiny, and they both do grow in the United States, and they both cause an itchy rash. So you really do want to stay away from both of them. If you are here in North Carolina, poison ivy is really what you want to watch for more, because that's what grows in North Carolina. Poison oak grows on the West Coast. So if you ever take a trip to California, or you have relatives that live in Oregon or Washington State, they might be looking out more for poison oak.
I saw that poison ivy is a hairy vine, and it's a vine, and it has like fuzzy hair on it, and those vines, buddy, they go deep and they go on forever. This is something that you need to have, you know, you don't need to be messing with. You need to tell your parents. But it says poison oak, so this can be a bush or a vine, so great. It's even more confusing. So it's really important that you really look at these pictures, those leaves, and then that stem is kind of like a red color, I see.
Like that too. The poison ivy also has kind of like a red stem.
So I see that this compare and contrast map just really kind of helps look at the similarities and the differences between the two. So thank you for sharing this.
You know, something else we could put in the middle is that Miss Palsgrove and Miss Miller want to avoid both of these.
Yeah. Yeah. And we could also maybe like extend it and put some ways that you can remedy it.
Ooh, yes.
I know we've tried lots of products, so yeah.
Yes, and I believe that they both, you know, are oil-based rashes. So if you're ever in California or Washington or Oregon on that West Coast and you get poison oak, you want to try the same strategies that you would try with poison ivy. You know, just soaked that oil off your body.
Yeah. All right. Well, we hope that everyone has a fantastic Thursday of teaching and learning, and we'll see you tomorrow on
Live Lucky.
Bye-bye.